I'm John Overall. We'll check back with Angelique in a little bit. Right now, we have the latest on the Mormon family killed in Mexico. Surviving members of that LeBaron family have left their homes there, and they have arrived here in Arizona. In an exclusive interview with our sister station, KPNX, Team 12 spoke with Emily Langford, who is related to the victims. News 4 Tucson's Lupita Murillo has our story.
The 9 women and children who were killed in Mexico near the border town of Douglas was believed to have been an attack by a drug cartel. Emily Langford struggled for words, but devastating is the word the families are feeling after losing their loved ones to violence one day, followed by losing their homes the next.
I can't even think of a word to describe how it feels to have to leave your home in such a devastating way.
The pictures tell the violence. Bullet holes in a torched SUV.
You have to go through your day. You have to stop crying. You have to focus on the people that are alive and get them what they need. But then when you start thinking about it.
Emily Langford knows the pain firsthand. Of those killed, there were her sister-in-law, niece, nephews, and cousins.
There's nothing there but bones and burnt bones.
After they had to say goodbye to their family this weekend, the family said goodbye to the fields they so long called home.
They didn't just take the lives of our loved ones and these innocent children. They killed the home. They killed our community and ripped it away from us because it will never be the same.
This weekend, 18 vehicles and more than 100 family members left, throwing everything they could into trucks and cars. And when they finally crossed the border into Arizona.
Joy. It was joy. It was the happiness, relief, a weight.
The family now safer, but after the loss of their loved ones and their homes, their focus is now on what's next.
And then we need enough time for them to rest, to just not be weary, to get their senses back.
Langford says that many members are still looking for homes and they would like to know if there are any spots where someone in the Phoenix area could help a family out to get back on their feet. They could also use some food or supplies. If you'd like more information, go to our website, KVOA.com. Lupita Murillo, News for Tucson.
The Pima County